Hello, everyone. Rob here with PreCodeCamp. And in this video, we're going to be going over PreCodeCamp's building a video compilation page. And we're just going to go from start to finish just to try to get you through the lab. So if you do have any questions, this video is going to be for you because we're going to be solving it and we're going to be going user story by user story. So I'll have it all chaptered out, but let's go ahead and dive into the problem. So if you're new and this is your first time taking a look at videos that we make, I am a coding instructor and I'm going to go through this as if I'm an instructor teaching it to students. And that way it might help you understand a little bit with the reasons why we're doing the things that we're doing. So anyways, right here, it tells us that this is the example project that we're going to be making. And it looks like we have like an H1 up here, a paragraph tag, maybe an H2 and some videos. And I will provide you guys with some iframes through a GitHub gist. So that way you can just copy and paste and put some of these things in here so that way you don't have to go hunting these things down in order to get that check mark of passing this lab. We're just going to go through user story by user story. And it looks like we have seven different user stories to go along with this. We have our test buttons that we can run as we're going through. And I typically wait until the end. That way I can see what am I missing when it comes down to running these tests. So I'm going to read them. This is my first time going through them as well in the video. We may make some mistakes, but we'll correct them as we go. So it's all about these tests that get to be ran. All right, so user story number one, it's really telling us right here, it says, we should have a main element as the only child inside of the body. And so whenever we have these elements here, such as body, we would consider this to be a parent, and anything that is nested inside of it could be children as well as grandchildren when we're referencing the body. So all it wants us to do is create a semantic tag. And again, we're not going to see anything on here, but this is more or less for screen readers when it comes to these types of elements. And so I'm just going to go ahead and do a main right here. And then I'm going to close off the main right here. And that should satisfy a user story number one. On to user story number two. It says here that we should have an H1 element with the topic of the page. And so let's take a look real quick at what it is wanting. And we can go ahead and copy this right here. So I'm going to go ahead and copy it. And let's go back to our page. And inside the main, we want to have an H1. How do we know that this is where it goes? Remember, it says the body should only have one child. And if we were to put it outside of the main, the body would have another child. And we don't want that. So inside the main, I'm just going to go ahead and hit the tab here. It needs to be an H1. Now, I'm always telling students whenever we're doing these tags in here, because sometimes it can get lost. And I would say create the opening tag, which is right here, and then go ahead and close it off. And then we'll worry about the text that goes in between it here. And I'm just going to go ahead and paste that. And now we should be able to see some appear on the right-hand side for our preview. So I'm going to go ahead and rearrange some of the windows here just so we can see what's going on here. Let's move on to the next user story. User story number three says we should have a paragraph introducing the topic just below our H1 element. Again, I'm going to come over here and I'm going to grab the text that they have. And again, I'm just using it as reference. It's really for us to check the block for having this complete. So underneath here, we want a paragraph tag, so that way we don't accidentally forget the closure. And then I'm going to go ahead and paste what I had there. You can see that on the preview, it's showing up. And this will go ahead and satisfy the paragraph element right underneath the H1 element. User story number four, it's telling us that we should have three section elements below our very first paragraph that we just got done putting on here. So what does that look like? Again, we still want to keep all of our stuff inside of the main. And I'm going to go ahead and hit the enter key here. What it's looking for is something here called a section. And again, it's just a semantic tag here for screen readers for separation of concern. I'm going to go ahead and close that off. Now it says that we need three of these. So I'm going to go ahead and copy each one of these, and that should satisfy user story number four for FreeCodeCamp. So user story number 5, it says that each section needs to contain an H2 element and it needs to have a paragraph and then an iframe element, and it needs to be in that order. And each one of these things that we're doing is going to go into a section. And what I'm going to recommend us doing, and that's what I'm going to do, is I'm going to get one of them perfect, and then it's easy for me to go ahead and duplicate. With that being said, let's take a look at what we're talking about with the example that they do give us. And so this is the part that we're here for, right? We're right below this paragraph. It says we want an H2. And so if we're looking at this, this right here is our section. And the very top here, that is our H2, followed by a paragraph, which is right here. And then we have an iframe. And so we're going to build this in that exact order. So heading back over to our sections here that we have, I'm going to go ahead and get one of them working properly. So the very first thing that we need is an H2. And I'm going to go ahead and close that off. Then it said that we need a paragraph. So I'm going to go ahead and do open and close for the paragraph. And then the iframe, for right now, I'm just going to put a comment in here. I'm going to put iframe here just so that I know where I can go ahead and delete later on. So it's just a little comment in here, and we can do this with a control slash or a command slash on the keyboard. So the H2, what did they have over there for their H2? And they had HTML, the other one had CSS, and then we had JavaScript for the other one. And so I'm just going to go ahead and do HTML on here as well. And then as far as the paragraph goes, I'm going to go ahead and grab this. I'm going to go ahead and copy that. And then I'm going to go ahead and put that in between the paragraph tags. All right. Now the iframe, again, you can go to YouTube. You can go grab whatever video that you would like. Again, I'm going to supply you in the description down below this video of the link for the gist. And when you visit the gist, it will have 3 videos on it. It already has the iframes on there. And really, all we would have to do is click on the raw button here, and we can go ahead and grab each one of these here. And I'm going to grab that one, and then I'm going to come over here to our page that we're building, and then I'm going to go ahead and paste that iframe. So now I see that I do have a video showing up here, and it should match the iframe that we're wanting to get for when we're doing the test here. So next, we're going to go ahead and do the rest of these. And so I'm just going to go ahead and come into here. We want to do an H2, and then we're going to close that off. So maybe in retrospect here, copy and pasting might not have been the best. And so I'm just going to go ahead and put these in here. It's not going to be too hard to do this. And then we'll go ahead and put that comment here, iframe here. So as far as other H2, I'm going to come back over here. I'm just going to grab the CSS, come back, paste that there. As far as the paragraph goes, again, just trying to make things easy on ourselves. And FreeCodeCamp didn't give us the ability to make it easy for the iframe videos, but that's what I'm going to be giving you guys to put for your iframe. Below here, I'm going to go back to the gist. I'm going to grab the next iframe and put that in there. And there we go. So that's, we got 2 of them done. And you can see that we have the CSS, and then we have the other one here also. Next is this very last one. Just going to do the same thing, H2s, paragraph tags, and then let's go ahead and grab what we need for it. This one was JavaScript for the H2, and I'm going to go ahead and manually type that part in, but at least I can paste the paragraph, and this is going to be JavaScript. And then the iframe, and I'm just going to grab that last one here for the video 3 and paste that in here. Again, just trying to keep things nice and simple for everyone. And if I scroll through here, I see the JavaScript, I see the CSS, and then I see the HTML. And this also satisfies, it looks like, user story number 6, because it says that it needs to have a source with a valid video. So here is our source. So each one of them do have a source. And then the last part here, it says it needs to have a title. And so each one of these, they do have a title. And then the last thing here is the height and width. And each one of these iframes, they do have a height and width associated with it. I guess what we ended up doing was 5, 6, and 7. We combined them all with this. And now it's time to run these tests and hopefully we get a completion. So it looks like we're good to go with that. All right, so hopefully you enjoyed this video. Like I said, make sure that you like, subscribe, let us know how this video helped, and if there's any other videos that you may want us to do and take a look at, and maybe we can put that in a different order as far as making them. Thanks again, and we'll see you in the next video. Take care.